my channel. So for today's video, I want to talk about something low-key stressful that happened to me. One of the problems that I encountered was that my vinyl did not want to stick to my shirt. So I'm going to start the story from the beginning. My dad told me, hey, I want you to put my name in the back of my shirt. I had already made him a Father's Day shirt and he just wanted me to add his name to the back because I had done that for another customer. And I was like, yeah, sure, no problem. That's like the easiest thing, you know, name's not that hard. So I was like, okay, perfect. I did the design. I cut it. Well, the Cricut cut it. I was good to go. I turned on my heat press. I don't change nothing. Normally, the way I do one shirt is the same way I do another shirt. I don't change the process. I don't do no changing, no temperature change, no nothing. Everything stays the same. So I turned on my heat press. I pressed it like I normally would. When I went to remove the backing, some of the letters started coming up. And this has never happened to me before. It has never happened to me before. So I thought, oh, maybe it's just a bad press. So I took the whole backing out. And I want to say that it wasn't even the whole letter that was coming off. It was kind of just like the tip. Like you can tell, or like the corners. And you can tell that the corners just didn't like stick. So I lifted it all the way and I just pressed it without the backing. I just pressed it for like 3 to 4 seconds. And that kind of made them stick, but I wasn't satisfied. But at the same time, I was like, well, I don't know what I could do. It was sticking. I let it cool. I let it cool for like 10 to 15 minutes. When I went back after it had cooled, I checked it and it looked fine. But I mean, I still wasn't convinced because of what I had seen. The next day was Father's Day. My dad wore the shirt, I want to say the entire day. Towards the end of the day, the letters were flying. Like they did not stick to the shirt at all. Like half of each letter was like hanging. I mean, they were hanging on for dear life. Like they were flying. And I was like, oh my gosh, that is so embarrassing. So I told my dad, you know what, dad, take the shirt off and just wear the other one that I had gotten you. Because my mom bought him one shirt from my collection for Father's Day and I had gifted him another one. So I was like, just wear the shirt that my mom gave you. So he did. He took it off. And so in my mind, I was like, I'm going to try to do it again and see what's going on. But in my mind, I was like freaking out because I was like, I didn't change the process at all. So in my mind, I thought it can't be the temperature because the temperature is what the instructions say. And I was like, it can't be the pressure because I mean, how could it be? I've been making shirts for like almost 2 months. I would have had this problem before if it was the pressure. So I didn't know what was going on. I decided that night, I decided to watch YouTube videos on, you know, pretty much what happens when your vinyl doesn't stick. None of them really made me be like, oh, you know what? It has to be that. So what I decided to do was the next day, which was a Monday, I contacted the people where I purchased my vinyl from because they have been super, super helpful. Like the guy that I speak to, he knows that I'm new to this. I have no idea what I'm doing. And he's very helpful. He sends me videos. He lets me know what I'm doing wrong. So in my mind, I was like, even though I didn't buy the heat press from them, let me just reach out. Maybe he can send me a video. Maybe he can help me out or maybe not. Who knows? But I was like, it doesn't hurt to ask. And that's another thing too. When you have a business, don't assume you have all the answers and you know what you're doing. Ask for help. If you need that help, just ask, you know, put your ego aside, just ask. I'm not afraid to ask questions because at the end of the day, I'm new to this. You know what I'm saying? I'm new. I know I don't have all the answers. I'm gonna, you know, end up making mistakes, but you can avoid making more mistakes if you ask for help. So that's why I love to ask for help, or I love to ask questions. So I ended up sending him the email. I ended up also sending an email to the company where I bought the heat press from. And in my mind, I'm like, let's just see what they both say. So the place that I emailed first, which is where I get my vinyl from, they didn't reply back until like a week later. But the people where I got my heat press from, they replied that same day, but like at night because of the time difference. So they pretty much were like, you know, have you checked your temperature? You know, and I was like, yes, I have. You know, everything's the same. I even sent them pictures. So then they pretty much were like, okay, have you done the pressure test? And I was like, no, I don't know what that is. But in my mind, I was like, I was still stuck on the, it can be the pressure because I've done, you know, other shirts, the other shirts would have been ruined. I was still stuck on that. But in my mind, I was like, you know what? Let me just do the pressure test. Let me just do the pressure test. You never know. Let's just do it. Okay, so I am going to be doing the pressure test now. So wish me luck because I've never done this. And hopefully I do it right. So they said in the video that you're supposed to have like an inch. You have to put the paper in like at least an inch. And then you have to press it down. Hopefully the paper stays. So about an inch. And then if it moves, like if you can take it out, then that means that the pressure is not good. So now we're gonna try it by cutting it in half because that's what they said. They said you have to cut it in half. So I'm gonna cut it in half. Try this again. So it's supposed to only be like an inch in. Yeah, so it's not moving at all. So that means that the pressure is really good. So now you're supposed to fold this in half and try it like that. So let's try this test again. It's not moving at all. I hope you guys can see, but it's not moving at all. So that means that the pressure is good. Unless I'm doing it wrong, but because normally when I would heat press, I wouldn't go all the way down. I would do it like this, and yeah, you can see that if I do it like how I do it, the pressure is horrible. So we're gonna adjust it. See, it's still like leaves. So it still comes with me. So I'm kind of like confused. It still comes with me. Maybe I'm not doing it right. If I do it like this, it doesn't come. But if I do it like this, it's super easy. So I don't know, maybe I'm not doing it right. But basically, so this pretty much, to me, this shows me that the way I'm gonna do this shirt is by going all the way down so that it can click. Hopefully that way it gets the right pressure. So I'm gonna try it that way and hopefully we don't burn the shirt. I always have to make sure it's nice and straight because if it's not nice and straight, we're not gonna get a good shirt. It's a little off. I'm probably gonna do it like this. I think that's fine. Okay, so let us pray. Let's see what happened now. Okay. Oh, wow. So we're gonna do it one more time for like a few seconds
So three, okay, cool. So yeah, I think it worked. Not like it's like perfect. Wow. So it was the pressure. The guy was absolutely right.
This is how the shirt ended up coming out. As you guys can see, it looks really good. It was definitely the pressure. This shirt, I've had it for, I want to say, 2 weeks now. I'm not too sure. But I just washed it today. So the reason why I'm showing it to you guys is because I washed it today and it looks really good. So I washed it in the washer and I hanged dried it. I put it outside so it can dry. And it looks really good. Like really, really good. There's no part that's like coming off. It's like up in the shirt. And I'm just so happy because, I mean, I didn't make a sell for like 2 weeks because all of my sales are coming from me making t-shirts. So during those 2 weeks, I realized my business solely depends on me making shirts. So that's why I was a little scared because I didn't know what was wrong. I didn't know if it was a heat press that was wrong that I had to return. Because in my mind, I was like, I literally just got it in April. And I was like, how can something be wrong? But another thing that I do want to say is when it comes to the vinyl not sticking to your shirt, it can be a lot of things. It can be a lot of different things. It doesn't just have to be the temperature or the pressure or the calibration, however you call it. It can be a lot of other things. I think I seen in a video that if you don't like lick it, like when you take out the lint, if you don't do that to like the extreme where you remove a lot of the times your vinyl won't stick. So it can be a lot of different things, like a lot of different things. It can also be that you're using the wrong vinyl. I did see someone's comment from another video that they had said that they tried making a shirt with the vinyl that Cricut gives you when you first buy the machine. And that's a big no-no. The material that Cricut sends you, which is like little samples, those are like cardstock and like something totally different. They don't give you vinyl. They do not, at least mine didn't come with vinyl. And if they do give you vinyl, like I don't know if they send different sample packs, but if for whatever reason yours does come with vinyl, it'll probably be decal vinyl, which is the one that you can stick to like bumpers and like windows and stuff like that. It's definitely not going to be for sure because the material that you use for a shirt is heat transfer vinyl. And there's also other types of heat transfer vinyl that you can also use for shirts. But that's normally like the normal one that usually is the most common one. But yeah, so there's a lot of things that can go into play. Just make sure that you're reading your directions. And like I said before, don't hesitate to ask for help. Let me know. Comment down below if you need any help when it comes to your vinyl. And we could figure it out together because it's not something that's super hard. If you try everything and it's still not sticking to your shirt, I would recommend you to email the person that you bought the heat press from, and they'll either give you a refund or they'll send you a video. You never know. So with that being said, thank you guys so much for watching, and if you like today's video, please give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe, and I'll see you guys in my next video.